bell button.
Next, torque current analogies. So this is the given mechanical rotational system. So these are all the torque current analogous equivalents. For example, here in mechanical rotational system, input is torque, but its equivalent electrical is current, because torque current. Next, for dashpot in rotational system, we have to use one by resistor as electrical equivalent. Similarly, for omega, it means angular velocity equal to voltage in electrical circuit. For moment of inertia, we have to use capacitor. For spring, we have to use one by inductor in the electrical system. So now, similarly, like torque voltage analogy, here also we have to consider how many number of moment of inertia are available. So here there are two moment of inertia are available. So therefore, in the final circuit diagram, we'll be having two nodes. So therefore, there are two moment of inertia elements. Therefore, there are two nodes. So this is one, this is two. Therefore, the voltage at this point is V1, the voltage at this point is V2. So in between this point and this point, there is a common element. Its equivalent electrical element is inductor. Therefore, so this inductor is the common element between these two nodes. So therefore, here L1. So now, at this point alone, J1 is connected and B1 is connected, and also there is a torque here. So for this, equivalent is current. Therefore, there is a current source I of t. It is connected with this point. So now, apart from this J1, its equivalent is C. Therefore, a capacitor connected, its value is C1. As I already told, J capacitor. So here J1, therefore here C1. Next, for B1, its equivalent is resistor, 1 by resistor. But here we have to use R only instead of 1 by R. Therefore, here for B1, R1. Now, node 1 part is over. Next, we have to mark for node 2. So for node 2, there are 3 elements, J2, K2 and B2. For J2, we know already C. Therefore, we can use C2. Next, for B2, its equivalent is 1 by resistor, but in the electrical circuit, we have to use R only. Therefore, R2. For K, inductor, instead of 1 by L, so we have to use L only in the electrical circuit. So L, but here B2, therefore L2. So this we can consider as reference node. Its potential is 0 volt. So now we know current through this capacitor is potential across these two points. This is the potential across between or across the capacitor. So this is capacitance value. By using basic formula, we can calculate the current through this capacitor. So now similarly, we know the potential across these two points. So we can calculate the current through the resistor. Similarly, we can mark the current through in this inductor, this capacitor, this resistor and this inductor. So we know this is the input current. So that is I. So now this is, at this point, this is entering current. Definitely this is leaving current IC1. This is also leaving current IR1. This IL1 also leaving current at this point. But at this point, so this is the entering current IL1. So here, this is the leaving current IC2. This is also leaving current IR2. This is also leaving current IL2. So according to the nodal analysis, so now here source current I of t equal to current through this capacitor. It means potential is V1 minus 0 divided by current through capacitor is, so current through capacitor IC equal to C into dV by dt. Therefore, C into here C1 dV1 divided by dt, because here potential across this capacitor is V1 minus 0. Therefore, dV1 by dt plus next current through this resistor equal to, according to Ohm's law, V1 divided by R1 next plus. So current through this resistor is potential across these two points, these two points. Therefore, potential across inductor or these two points is V1 minus V2 divided by R. We already know current through inductor equal to IL equal to 1 by L integral of I into dt. So this is the formula V into dt. So here V1 minus V2 potential integral dt. So here we have to use 1 by L. Here L is L1. So now we can say this is equation number 7. Similarly, we have to apply the nodal analysis at node 2. At node 2, so now at node 2 there is no source. So now here arrow mark is towards this inductor. Because there is no source here, it means sum of current through all the element equal to 0. First we can consider this C2. So here therefore C2 into its potential is V2 minus V2 minus reference V2 minus 0. Therefore dV2 divided by dt plus next element R2 potential across the resistor R2 is V2 minus 0. Therefore V2 by R2 plus current through this inductor is we know 1 by L. Here L2 integral of potential between these two points or potential across the inductor is V2 minus 0. Therefore V2 into dt plus there is a common element. So now current through this element is 1 by L1 integral of. So we know now current through this inductor is potential across these two points. So this is the formula. So here V is V2 minus V1 because now potential across in this inductor is V2 minus V1 because now we are writing the nodal equation for this node 2. Therefore V2 minus V1 into dt. So now we can consider this as equation number 8. So now equation number 7 and 8 are the equations for torque current analogous circuit.